So I managed to cut all the stickers today. I only had a few left, but yeah, I'm so happy that I finally finished cutting them. And I really like how they look. They look so colorful all together. And I kind of do want to start packing them now, but I think I'm just gonna wait for a bit until my boyfriend is home this evening and ask if he will help me. Because packing them always takes me like so long, because I all sort them out before packing them and then I have to do the actual packing. So yeah, I think I'm just gonna leave them like this for now and maybe start packing them tonight. Also have to cut all of these prints, so yeah, I think I'm gonna start on these because I know this will take me a little while. And if you're asking why I print my prints like this, it is just way cheaper for me this way. And I do have like a paper cutter that cuts them really nicely. So yeah, I am a really small business and I don't have much money to spend on like products. And also these stickers are kind of expensive to make, even though I cut them out myself, which is way cheaper than, you know, ordering them like die cut stickers. But yeah, I just try to save money this way and for me it really works. In the future I will probably like order them all cut and stuff, but yeah, for now this is fine. Especially the prints, I really like how I'm able to make like more prints now because it is cheaper this way. So I'm going to cut these now. Thank you. it is Voiceover Kim here. I don't think I've talked much in this video yet, so I thought that I would do a bit of talking now while I do some packing. I am packing these Inktober stickers from last year in little surprise bags. I explained a little bit in a few videos back, but basically I have a lot of seconds of these that are actually like really beautiful and like there's not actually something wrong with them. So I thought that I would just pack them up in little surprise bags and still sell them for like a really good price, because I just don't want them to go to waste. So, but anyway, I thought this was a good moment to talk about Inktober this year, because all these stickers are illustrations I did last Inktober, so Inktober 2019, and I'm really thinking about Inktober already and if I should participate again, because I did it for the last 2 years, I think. Or maybe, I think I did Inktober last year and then in 2017, if I'm right, but I'm not sure. But I do think that I really want to participate this year again, but I'm just not really sure what to do yet, because I don't think I'm going to follow a list. I never have followed a list. I did take some inspiration from a few lists here and there, but I never like followed one specific list or prompt list. And I don't think I will do that this year, but honestly, I'm not sure yet. Also, I'm really hesitant if I'm just going to use my sketchbook, because I really want to fill up my sketchbook, and that definitely will really help fill up my sketchbook. But on the other hand, I really like to have all my Inktober drawings and paintings like together in one sketchbook or whatsoever, so I'm not really sure yet. I'm also thinking of just cutting up some paper and just make like 31 really small cute illustrations and sell them for like a really small price at the end of Inktober. And I think that sounds really fun as well, because I do like the idea of all my Inktober drawings getting a home, because I don't know what to do with all these drawings. I did sell my Inktober drawings of last year as well, and I have sold a few, but I still have a lot of them, so if you do want to check them out, they are still in my Etsy store. But yeah, I'm not really sure what to do yet for medium as well, because I have seen a few people use watercolors with Inktober, and honestly I kind of just want to do that instead and just like do the whole drawing or painting every day but not really using ink. But then, you know, it's called Inktober and I also kind of do want to use ink, but at the same time I kind of just want to use my sketchbook and do some, you know, watercolor paintings to just fill up my sketchbook. I'm really not sure what to do yet, as I'm sure you can tell, but yeah, I'll see. For now, I'm just gonna leave you with the rest of this video, and I will see you in my next video. And also, if you're going to participate, please let me know if you have any like plans yet, or if you have also no idea like me, because I would really like to hear. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Bye! So it is Future Kim here editing. this video, but I actually realized that I deleted the footage of me actually packing these, so I just wanted to show you quickly what they look like, because yeah. But yeah, I think they look really cute. I like that you can kind of see them in the little bag, and they have been up on my Etsy for a little while now, and I actually sold quite a few already, so if you do want to pick one up, then the link will be in my description. So yeah, that's all I wanted to say.